And today I'm at the DJI booth at NAB 2023, and we're gonna look at the brand new Inspire 3, which is like amazing. And one of the guys I'm actually gonna have show it to you is Pranan Wolf. We actually go way back to the launch event from the original Inspire 1. Hey everyone, here at the DJI booth, we're gonna look at the brand new Inspire 3, and Pranan Wolf here is gonna tell us all about it. I'm gonna pass it off to you.
I will. My name is Pranan Wolf. Welcome to the DJI booth at NAB 2023. I'm a senior product manager at DJI and also the creative director for Europe. And today I want to talk about our new and latest drone for professionals, the Inspire 3, or in short, i3. Recognize it in Inspire because it's still compact and ultra portable, so you can still, you know, put it on a backpack, go wherever you want. And you also still can put it on board of an aircraft and travel with it, because our new TB51 batteries, they're still below 100 watts, so you can put them in hand luggage. What's new? So first of all, the body design, we try to integrate it all the major parts. So the FPV camera now sits on top. It's a completely redesigned sensor, larger sensors than on the i2. It has a super wide angle lens with 161 degrees FOV. Very comparable to a normal, typical FPV drone. It is low light capable, so you can basically fly at night. And it has an ultra low latency video transmission system. So that all results in the possibility to fly the Inspire 3 via FPV camera. So in environments where you cannot have direct line of sight, like a forest or, you know, dense set, this is something that helps extremely to maneuver around objects and fly way closer and, you know, get more action-packed shots. We have a 360-degree obstacle avoidance system, so the sensors are now at the landing legs, nicely integrated. So it's omnidirectional, upwards, downwards, and basically 360 degrees. You can fully customize the system. So if you don't want the drone to stop or bypass a subject or object, you can just turn it to a way where you get visually and acoustically warned that an object is near. And that's especially helpful for professional pilots that always want to be in full control, but also want to benefit from, like, it's basically like a park assist on your car. So you get visual and acoustic warnings. Also include you know, proven vision sensing system with down-facing it is very stable, able to hover very precisely over one spot in one height, and there's a new software algorithm running on the system as well, which basically eliminates the need of using the compass. So it's purely relying on the sensors, and that makes it way more precise in flying straight lines. And it has another, or two other big benefits. So first of all, you don't need to calibrate your compass anymore very often. Basically, you don't have to calibrate it at all unless you travel far distances. So you don't get those compass errors anymore. And the other cool benefit is, if you rotate the gimbal 180 degrees, the horizon stays absolutely stable. So the gimbal operator doesn't have to, you know, compensate for a crooked horizon anymore. And that's all due to our new sensing system and the software algorithms that run on the drone. One of the main upgrades is the camera. We have now a purposely custom built 8.1K full frame sensor, which is a huge upgrade to the Super 35 sensor we had on the X7. It is 8.1K video and 35 megapixel stills photos. So another cool feature is that we're now able to shoot 120 frames per second, 4K slow motion. And you're also flexible to set up different frame rates at different project settings. So you can undercrank, meaning that you shoot a 24 timeline with 21 frames. That's something which is often done on car commercials, to get that more dynamic look. We have 14.7 stops of dynamic range, and it's also a dual native ISO sensor. So the base ISO is 800, the upper ISO is 4000, which makes it very low light capable. It also uses the same color science as our Ronin 4D, which is great because that already has been proven on many professional film sets. And so overall, it's fair to say that this camera matches with the latest and greatest cinema cameras out there. So this won't be any limiting factor anymore. And that's especially important for an all integrated drone where you cannot change the camera, that you basically are allowed on set because the camera matches with the other cameras on set. So we integrated several professional codecs like ProRes RAW, ProRes 422 HQ and Cinema DNG. So that should cover all needs. We also have H.264, but on a drone of this level, most people will use ProRes, ProRes RAW or Cinema DNG. So with the X7, we had four lenses, the 16, 24, 35 and 50 mil, but that was a Super 35 sensor. So with a full frame sensor, you cannot use the 16 anymore because it was only for Super 35, but we have a new 18 mil lens, which you can see here. So that basically replaces the 16 mil. So you still have like a huge wide angle lens. So 18, 24, 35 and 50, and there will be a new telephoto lens coming out later. We updated our video transmission system. This is now O3 Pro. It goes up to 15 kilometers or 9 miles. And one of the key features is that it now allows the gimbal operator and the pilot to be separated. On the Inspire 2, you had a direct connection between the gimbal operator and the pilot, and they had to stay in the same area. Now the pilot could stand over there and the gimbal operator could stand at the other end of the hall. They just have a direct link, a dedicated direct link to the drone, which makes working on set way more seamless. The new O3 Pro also allows us to integrate our DJI ecosystem. So via the hybrid monitor that you know from the Ronin 4D and the HD transmission system, you now can also use the DJI Master Wheels to control the gimbal. It also allows you to use the Ronin 4D hand grips, if I may steal that for a second. So this is also, you can pull focus, you can control the gimbal, and you can also use our three-channel focusing unit, which allows you to have a three-person setup. So one pilot, one gimbal operator, and one person pulling focus in demanding environments. So there's also a new function called Tilt Boost. In previous Inspire generations, the lower landing gear position was only used for takeoff and landing, while the upper position basically allowed a 360 degree rotation of the camera, but you were always limited in the up tilt. So now, on the Inspire 3, in the lower landing gear position, it has a wider stance and it also lifts the nose of the aircraft up. This allows the camera to go up to 80 degrees upward without any obstructions, while also still be able to get all the way down. So you don't have to make a decision if you want to top mount the camera or bottom mount it like on other drones. You basically have both, and you don't have to switch back and forth. And that also makes you, enables you to create shots where you go from minus 90 degrees to plus 80 degrees. And that's something completely new. So I think those are the main features on the hardware side. I will talk about software soon. But one thing I wanted to show you, what we also took over from the Ronin 4D is the storage. We use a 1 terabyte DJI Pro SSD, and the nice thing about this is you don't need a card reader. So on set you can just give the SSD to your DIT or the data wrangler and he just blocks it in via USB-C, which is a huge benefit. So no handing out card readers and getting them back, just give them the SSD and they're ready to go. So on the software side, we have some pretty intelligent features. So first of all, if you work solo, We have the feature called Spotlight Pro, where you can just mark a subject and then automatically track it. So we, as a pilot, you can freely fly the drone and the gimbal will always stay locked on the subject. And then we also fully integrated Waypoint Pro. So there's no need for a third-party app anymore. You're all set right out of the box with a complete full-blown Waypoint system. And that has two different modes. Waypoint Pro has repeatable routes where you can fully program the flight path and the gimbal orientation of the drone, which makes it very easy to program complex shots and repeat them very reliably. For instance, if you want to do a transition between daylight and nighttime, or between two different seasons at the same location, at the same spot, you can perfectly do that with the Waypoint Pro repeatable route feature. And there's one other great thing about the Inspire 3. It has dual integrated GNSS antennas that support RTK. So if you add an RTK base station or a network RTK, you get centimeter level precision on the Inspire 3. That's especially important when you do those waypoint missions, because you obviously want those to be exactly the same if you want to merge them in post. So the second option of the Waypoint Pro feature is called 3D Dolly. So what it basically does, you can program a three-dimensional pass in the air. Think of it as like a railroad track, or you know, a dolly track. And then you can control the speed and direction of the aircraft along this track. So for the pilot, it just controls the speed. The pass is already preset, so he can just purely focus on getting the right timing. And the gimbal operator can freely control the gimbal. So this is especially helpful in complex shots on sets, you know, where the actors and the action can always have a different timing. You just eliminate one variable, the flight path. It's always the same, and you just fully focus on the timing. So this is huge, and it will enable new possibilities in filmmaking, because you can do repeatable moves with the drone. They can be ultra complex, and you can do it each time according to the action. So this is a really, really big benefit. There's one new thing as well, it's a remote controller. So we use the RC Plus from our Enterprise line, which is very ergonomic. There's lots of buttons and dials that you can freely customize. Detachable antennas, integrated 7-inch 1200 nits display that's bright enough to work in full bright daylight without any shade or hood. Very, very helpful. You have a nice belly stand, which helps a lot if you film the whole day. And you can also use our new harness, which is very comfortable to wear. So you can just have the remote controller dangling in front of you the whole day. Very, very easy and convenient. We also have hot swapping functionality on the remote controller. So there's a slot for an external battery, which you can pop out. The remote controller still runs. And then you have about three hours internal battery life, and another three and a half hours of this, and you can just pop a new one in, and you don't have to turn off the remote anymore the whole day. That's really cool. And the same goes for the Inspire as well. It supports hot swap, so you can just remove one battery, pop a fresh one in, and then swap the other one. So you don't have to turn down the drone or the remote controller at all day. You can just leave it on, which is very, very helpful on professional sets as well. So I think that's it.
Anyway, I'm interested in you guys' thoughts. Drop your thoughts underneath in the comments. Let me know what you think about this. And if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my videos. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.